Yo, what's up, fellas? It's your boy Al, and today we're going to be visiting backdrops. Something cool, right? Listen, a lot of people out there have great, great layouts. I've seen a lot of them. They look really good, but without a backdrop, it takes a lot away. I feel personally, in order to bring your layout from good to excellent, you know, on the level of professionals or whatever, you need a backdrop, something you should plan from day one of building your layout. It's not something that you want to start after your layout. You want it to be a part of the plan, and I'm going to show you why in this how-to video, which is also going to show you how to paint mountains and things like that. It's pretty easy, so we're going to be checking that out. Simple as using, of course, acrylic paint from Walmart, 50 cents. You guys know I've been talking about this for a long time. So cheap, easy to do, so we're going to check that out. And I'm going to share to you how mine looks, how I built mine, mad easy. All right, so let's get started. Okay, here's my layout. You've seen it hundreds of times. All of it is backdropped. You can see the background mountains as well as the foreground mountains. Backdrop all the way over here. This is much higher than the other stuff because I don't have to go, you know, I don't have to come in from that other side over there to touch anything, so it'll be as high as I wanted it to be. And as you notice over there, it's much, much lower. It's because I have to be able to get over there for access to the tracks. So a short backdrop, because of the obvious reasons of getting onto the other side for derailments and everything. But I have this hung up there, just kind of giving it, you know, a little more realism. It's a little bit higher. And over here, you can see there's not one. I haven't finished it. Okay, here we go. As you can see, I was goofing around. I just spray painted my name there. I just did it. I don't care. That's my old fascia cloth right there. Old school. Anyway, let's get back to backdrops. As you can see here, this is the cheapest stuff out in Home Depot. It's like literally $7 a sheet. It's the cheapest, ugliest color wood paneling. It's only $7 a sheet. And I cut it right where these things are. Cut them right there at whatever length I want them to be, or I can make it be 24 inches high, which is what the standard size I think is good. 24 inches, and you have 24 inches uniform around your layout if you don't need to reach access anywhere else. So this is mad cheap, and you need support braces for these because it's really thin and it warps or whatever. So let's take a look at this stuff. This is very sturdy, but it's a little bit harder to cut, you know, going over with the razor blade over and over. And as you notice behind here, I have supports. There are supports here that go up, not any measure. I'm not gonna tell you, almost 2.3 feet every one. No, it was just wherever I felt like it needed to go. So I put them up, braces, of course, to protect it. Now let's get into, this right here is 24 inches wide, and then it connects over there. Now let's get into how they did it real fast. So it's not perfect, but it's good because I can show you the example. The two ends meet right here. You can see the line there. Typically, what I do is just tape and mud. This one was this one wasn't taped, so you see it didn't last too well. But I tape, mud it, sand it. You don't need to sand it perfectly like you would, and that's how that's done. This one right here needs to be done, needs to be finished. But as you can see, as I explained to you, the screws go right to the front, and then I'll mud right here, mud over that, nice and pretty and stuff, you know, and then paint it. Okay, so now I'm gonna explain to you why you want to plan for your backdrop to be put up while you're building the layout during the beginning, not in the middle or the end stages. It needs to be a part of the planning during the beginning. At some point, you're gonna put it up. So, what I like to say is the reason is simple, because if it's against the wall like this is right here, and if you don't put the support beams up right here, this is the support beams, make sure you put these up every few feet, and then you can do your bench work. Don't even worry about the backdrop at that point, as long as you got the support beams up, because when you get the backdrop and you decide to put it up, you're going to want to put it up against something and screw it in. Now let's get to the fun part. Painting a backdrop. This is really easy. What I did here was I chose a color blue that worked for me. There's many cool blues out there. I just like to say that you don't want to pick the bluest blue because it doesn't look realistic. So you pick a blue that's, you know, look in the sky. Just basically pick something out in your region that it's going to be something like. The clouds are done pretty easy. There's stencils they sell out there for $8.99. I use spray paint to up the clouds. This is what I did for my backdrop. As you can see, I have a desert scenery, so I use a tan in the dark. So let's say we're going to paint background one first. You can use this, add white to it, and that makes it lighter. So, you just go like this. and I'll start here. Okay, background done, right? There you go. So you're gonna go lighter in the front. Tan, perfect. Mix it up because of the previous color that was in there. So I'll mix it up so it's a little bit more even in color. Doesn't need to be perfect. So just like mine, I would do something similar like this. Now you want to consider that this up here would be dry, this color, okay? Because when you go like this, it's going to blend. Might get darker, but it doesn't have to be darker. I mean, it doesn't have to be completely dry, because blending is good, but I started with mine being dry. And you'll get blends, like you'll get like a shadow on this side, as you see. I'm not a paint expert, so just remember that, you know.
There you go, there's a foreground.
Now, on my layout, you can see I also added cactuses and some green vegetation, which is easy to do. I have a green here. For this example, in this how-to, I'm going to use the same brush. I don't think it's going to matter much. And for my desert scenery, I tend to just put dots all around. I haven't done trees, but I don't know. Let me try a tree. I'll try one right here live. Let's see. Not too bad, not too bad. That would be obviously a really close cool foreground Christmas tree type. It was not to have a masterpiece backdrop, but to have something that is back there that looks good. And like mine is back there, you can see the scenery makes the scene, but the background adds to it, adds depth. And as you look from a distance, I used colors just to show this, to put this together. I used a few quick colors. Now you study the area that you're modeling, and you know how the background
maybe
looks.
Maybe in your area, some people use purple and stuff, but no.
For me, just the background is being gray, works good. And painting it back there with the foreground front painted, and you have a backdrop. And I'm done for tonight. I'm gonna have to edit this video, get it all in, put some hot beat in the background, and that's gonna be the end, alright? Peace out!